Welcome students, myself Akshay Kumar Srivastan. This is my new video of class 7th. New chapter is chapter 5, Introduction to Photoshop, and today's topic is that is given on your book page number 67, background and foreground colors, and working with some important Photoshop tools that is given on page number 68, 69, 70 and more. Okay, so rectangular marquee tool, move marquee tools, and the move tool, copying a selection in same image. So we will start. Okay, so first I tell how we can open a Adobe Photoshop. Okay, so you will, I think all of you also know, I will show you. If you want to open, then you have to click on start, and then you have to click on all programs. Okay, and then from here you have to select that Adobe Photoshop. Okay, here is that set, and then click. When you click, that will be open, that window will open. I have already opened for you. Now this window and this picture I will open for you. So I will show you tools in the Photoshop toolbox. This is that is given on your page 66, various tools. Okay, so tools, so look, this is a rectangular marquee tool. Okay, that is one number. That is a move tool. This is second number given on your book. This is third. This is a lasso tool. That is a magic wand tool. This is a wand tool. Okay, this is a crop tool. Okay, and the slice tool is not given. And this is a brush tool. Okay, that is this clone stamp, very eraser tool. Okay, this is a gradient tool. Various tools are given here, and that is a eyedropper is here, eyedropper tool. This is eyedropper tool. Okay, and this is a hand tool. This is a zoom tool. Look here. Okay, various tools are here. All tools are helping. Okay, so what's next is a background and foreground colors. So you know that background, the backside colors, and foreground, the upper side color. Two overlapping boxes given below the toolbox display the foreground and the background colors being currently used by Photoshop. The foreground color is used by Photoshop to paint, fill, and stroke selections. The background color is filled in the erased parts of a drawing. Photoshop also uses the background color to make the ending color in the default gradient fields. That type of box, this is the foreground color and this is the background color. And here, if you want to click here to swap the foreground and background colors, default foreground and background colors is a black and white. Here is written, the default foreground and background colors in Photoshop are black and white respectively, but you can change these colors through the color picker dialog box. The bottom part of the toolbox. The steps to change the foreground or background colors are, click on the foreground color box to open the color picker dialog box, drag the slider to display different colors combination in the color selection box, click on a required color from the color selection box, and click on OK button. The foreground color will change accordingly. You can also change the foreground and background colors in many other ways, including using the eyedropper tool. You will learn about these as you proceed further in Photoshop. Okay, so I will show you how we can change the foreground or background colors. Here, look, this is a foreground color, that is okay, and this is a background color. So if you want to set the foreground color, then click on that, and that window will open for foreground colors. Okay, so which color you want, then you have to select. This is a slider, which color you want, then you have to select, and here is a foreground color shown and here is a background color shown. If you want to this blue, okay. Now look, that foreground color is changes. This is the swapping, okay, through which you can swap that, switch foreground and background colors. And this is the default. If you want to go back on default black and white, then you have to click here. Now we have to set the background color, click here. And this is a background color options are available. Move the slider, which color you want, if you want to that yellow or okay, then you have to click on ओके लुक हियर दैट बैकग्राउंड कलर ऑल्सो चेंजेस. ओके स्टूडेंट्स आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टैंड. इफ यू हैव अ सिस्टम देन यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस इट. नाउ वर्किंग विथ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फोटोशॉप टूल्स. लेट अस नाउ लर्न अबाउट सम फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज फोटोशॉप टूल्स एंड हाउ दे कैन बी यूज टू एडिट आवर manipulate an image. Rectangular marquee tool. The rectangular marquee tool is a selection tool. It is used for selecting an image or part of an image in a rectangular way. After selecting an image, we can cut, copy, delete, move or manipulate it any other way. The steps to select an image using these tools are as follows. Open the required image by using the open options of the file menu. Press the control and plus keys to increase the image size and control and minus key to decrease the image size. Click at the rectangular marquee tool in the toolbox. Bring the mouse pointer at a required place in the image and drag the to enclose the area that you want to select. A dashed moved border known as marquee will appear around the area showing that it has been selected. So selecting using rectangular marquee tool, I will show you. This is my picture already open. That is my nephew drawn that type of cake. Okay. Now click here and okay, that is a rectangular marquee tool. If you want to increase the size, then you have to look control plus F. Okay. And if you want to decrease, then control plus minus. Okay, I am pressing that control plus to increase the size and CTRL do. CTRL and I am pressing the CTRL minus to decrease the size. Okay, which you want, then you have to easily, this is the marquee tool. Okay, and more marquee tools are also available. Look, elliptical marquee tool, single row marquee tool, single column marquee tool. That is also given on your book. More marquee tool, elliptical marquee tool, single row marquee tool and single column marquee tool. So select the elliptical marquee tool to select an image or part of it in a circular way or elliptical way. Okay, and this is a single using selection using single row marquee tool. Select the single row marquee tool to select a single row of pixels in an image, and this is a single column marquee tool. Okay, so once we have selected an area in the image file, we can move it, copy it some other location in the same or a different files, delete the selected area, recolor it and do many other things with it. Okay, so I will show you. That is a rectangular. If you want to then okay, look, this is a rectangular. Now we have to click elliptical. That is a elliptical. Sorry, now elliptical. This is elliptical. Okay, this is the elliptical marquee tool. And now if you want to then single row, then click here single row. Oh, sorry, single row marquee tool. Okay, this is the single row. And if you want to select it, then you have to click here and single column marquee tool. Okay, this is the single column through which we can cut, copy, move our image. Okay, now next is a move tool. The move tool is used to move an image or a selected part of an image from one location to another. The steps to use the move tool are as follows. Click on the move tool in the toolbox. Second, place the mouse pointer over the image or the selected part of an image. Third, click and drag the mouse to the image or the selected part of the image to another location. Fourth, to reverse the changes you have to cause to image, press the Ctrl, Alt and Z keys. Remember, you can use the move tool to move a whole image anywhere in the image window without making any selection. Just select the move tool, bring the mouse pointer over the image and drag it any directions. The image will move in the image window. So I will show you how we can move. Okay, so click on that move tool. This is the move tool. Okay, and place the mouse pointer over the image or the selected part of the image. Look here, okay, that you can easily, this part is, you can, if you want to move that part, then you can easily move that part, okay, whole part if you want, then you can whole part you move, okay. This is the move tool, okay. Copying a selection in the, that is, I think all of you understand. Thank you.